What's up, guys? What is up? We return to Ark Survival Evolved in the Tribe Wars season, as I'm titling it, and that's a dimorph. I thought it was a bat that was going to attack us for a second. I'm like, no! Anyways, we return. We are in the area that I want to claim, at least, and hopefully I haven't neglected something major and someone's already built here, because that would be absolutely awful. But so this is a pretty strategic area, and if we can make use of it, we will reap the benefits. Now, I ended off last episode asking if we could actually build in the water. That's something we're going to find out today, because we kind of have to build anyway, because we need a base, because I'm going off on a journey to the beautiful city of LA, so I'm not going to be on Ark for a couple days. So we actually have to make sure that nothing stupid happens. You know, that would be very good if nothing bad happened to us. So what we can do here is get ourselves a wood foundation, craft that up, and I want to see if we can place it underwater. If not, no big deal. We'll find a place to place it, but I just want to see if we can make use of the water and actually build something underwater. And by the looks of it, we actually can. Huh. Well, if we can find a shallow... Oh, that's a piranha, that's a piranha, that's a piranha! No! Run, 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 run. Well, low-key, we might then make our PvP base actually in the water, because then it would be very hard for people to come and attack us. Because if someone were to come and try to attack us, this is like theoretically, this is my game plan, this is why I think our PvP base might be good, is that if we go underwater, you know, you can't really shoot your gun. You can shoot, oh my god, that's a lot of piranhas. Nope, 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 nope. Actually, we might be able to build on that little coral reef there. I don't know if that'll like help us and bring up the foundation a little bit. Oh, that's a level 60. If we could kill this thing, that's some easy XP. Hey, get back here, piranha. I see you running. I want that XP from you, level 60. Oh no, oh no, not like that, not like that. I wanted easy XP, not actually having to fight for it. Come on, die. Level me up, you piranha. Piranhas are actually awesome sources of XP, if I'm not mistaken, especially when they're at high level. And yeah, we got 15-ish XP from that. That's really not too shabby. Now let's go ahead, continue work on our health. I want it 150, then we'll start working on weight a little bit. And at this point in time, let's go ahead and get ourselves a base going. And now this base is going to be our PvE base that should be safe from harm. Actually, let's see some... Oh, hello, lag. Let's see something. I should probably collect that piranha before... No, that's an Argentavis. Argentavis, please have mercy on my soul. I don't want to fight you right now. Why is there an Argentavis here? We're going to that side of the island, but first things first, I want to collect my piranha. Oh, no. Yeah, he's not letting me. Well, it's just a couple of food. Whatever, we'll kill something. We'll get some more food later. It's all good. Ooh, we could actually build on that cliff, too. There's a lot of cool things we could do, man. I'm conflicted. So much opportunity. This is an awesome area. Seriously. Let's go ahead, hop on top of D. All these rocks and see, can we actually build on this? Is it obstructed? Really? Actually? No, it just depends on where you place it. So really, we can get to work on a base up here, and well, this would be a solid place to build, and really, we're gonna be safe from dinosaurs attacking us, so this might be a good place to have our PvP base built. Because, I mean, gigantosauruses and whatnot, they might be able to climb up here, you know, if they try really hard, but we'll have some forewarning. So yeah, this area's got some really strategic areas, but for now, let's build our PvE base, which we'll tuck away probably by the, by that cliff over by the water, maybe over there-ish somewhere. I think that's a solid spot. We just want to make sure that this one is close to wood. Definitely closer to this side so we can cross the mainland and already be pretty close to the inland like river and whatnot. So I think this area is gonna be pretty good. We'll go ahead and have it like hugging a wall. We'll do that, so move it back a little bit for good measure. Voila, we have that. So let's begin. Well, let's build a couple walls first to make sure that we don't place something in a very bad spot. So just go ahead and gather up some wood and thatch. We should have plenty of fiber for this. And this is just going to be the initial base building here. We're not going to go crazy. Unfortunately, I don't have the time to go nutty with it right now. As much as I would love to. I would actually love... Oh, we got to level up. Good thing we just got these engrams and we can put that into some walls. And with those walls, let's craft up two of them, exactly what I wanted. We want to at least level up to the point where we can get some wooden ceilings. So we need two more, four more levels. Wow, we need to kill some stuff quickly. What can we really kill to get XP though? I mean, there's piranhas in the river, which should be pretty easy source of it actually. We'll figure that out in a sec. For now though, let's just put a couple of these down and work around these. So throw down our storage box and just kind of put some of our goods away. Make sure to lock it so people don't access it. There we go, access it. So let's throw... I mean, so much of that's going to be going bad. We'll throw the simple bed down in a bit. Everything else... Oh, standing torches, yeah. Don't put those anywhere yet. And the coal, we're not going to be using that. And organic polymer, is that really going to be put to use? All right, well, that looks good. Now just continue our journey of gathering a bunch of stuff and killing stuff as well. Let's actually kind of alternate here so we don't go crazy with monotony. Let's see if there's any piranhas on this side. There is a couple. Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Piranha. How do you do? I see you like making friends. I'll be your friend for the... Oh, no, you broke my spear. Never mind. I'm not being your friend. You're a douche nozzle. Get out of here. Okay, can I kill you now? Yeah, I can. Yeah, take my spear. Yeah, there we go. All right, that got us. We're already halfway to the next level. We just got to hit level... Oh my god, he's like dancing. It is cool that you actually grab the piranha right after you kill it, though. I don't remember that being a thing. So for now, though, let's get our catch. And, oh, more piranhas, more piranhas, more piranhas, definitely. Let's make sure not to die from these piranhas. Oh, even more. Jesus Christ, they're doing some damage to us. We should definitely throw down the, what is it? Well, let's put the bodies down. We got a couple minutes before these go bad. Oh, that's an attractive face. What is it? We should probably put that bed down before we do anything too crazy. All these are like level 8. Look at it. There we go. We killed that one too. Okay. Well, we're almost at level 7. I guess piranhas aren't the best when it comes to XP. Probably something like a raptor. Oh, hello. Don't float off. I need you. Get back here. Hey, raptor. No, you can't escape me. I need that meat. Hey. Hey, shrimp! Oh my god. Well, we've been out-diddly-did by a mega piranha. I'm not entirely sure what to say. Do we not get skin from these guys? Wait. That's a Sarco! No, 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 no! Why is there a Sarco? If we kill it, that's really good. If we die to it, that's really bad. Let's not die to it, please, please, please. He is so close. Why is there a Sarco already? Oh no, oh no, oh no. I am horrified right now. Why? Oh, he's probably like a high level 2. We could tame him, which would be really useful given the bay, but we don't really have means of taming anything right now. Seriously, let's have some prime meat. We need to get another campfire going. We don't have enough stones for a campfire. Okay. Let's pick up some stuff. Mainly some stones. Let's hope that, you know... Sarko's in a good mood today, and he doesn't want to... Oh, he's coming in our general direction, isn't he? He wants to come eat our face. Oh, yeah. Oh, God. Hey, Mr. Sarko, how you doing there? Please don't notice me. Please, senpai, go back. There you go. Go back to swimming. You know, nothing... He noticed us. Crap. Dip, dip, and dip. Can we get you, like, aggro the Anklo or something? Maybe... Maybe the Dillo. Can I interest you in some of these, you know? Okay, he's left again. He like goes back into the water. And, oh, he might attack the Anklo. Yes, yes, my son, yes. He'll probably die to the Anklo and then we can capitalize. Actually, once he gets really hurt, we could come in and clean up the... Oh, no, he's not going after the Anklo. It's a lie. It's a lie. This dude's the king of illusions. Well, let's lure him very far away and hopefully circle back because... I see him. Go attack that Anklo. Do it. I know you want to attack the Anklo. Oh, compies? Is this just one? Oh, no. It's more. They're going to start attacking, aren't they? That's the one thing I hate about compies. Okay. Oh, my God. There's a lot of compies in this area, isn't there? Why is life so hard? Actually, if we kill the compies, we should get some XP. Oh, no. The compies are ganging up on Dillos. I support that. I support that. Okay, let's, look from our perch. Yeah, he's still... He's so close to where we were, man. We can't go back to our base safely. Hey, Zeus, man. Hey, Zeus. Oh, he might attack the Anklo. He's attacking it. All right, well, the cleanup crew might have to come in here. The Anklo's not going to stay and fight. Yo, Anklo, come on. Finish him off. Show him who's boss. And as soon as he gets really bloody, I will then proceed to show him who's boss as well. I will help you out. First things first, you got to help me out, though. Do some damage to him. He's not even bloody yet. Come on, Anklo. Oh my god. He's not even bloody. He might legitimately kill the Anklo first. If that happens, I might cry. Okay, now I'm seeing some blood start forming. Let's make sure we're at max health. Let's poop. He's gonna destroy that Anklo first, isn't he? Well, we could try creating as many spears as possible and tossing them into him. Yes, sounds like a plan. Awesome. Get more wood. Make many spears. Game plan accomplished. Oh, shit. Oh, we can finish him off. Hey, buddy. How you looking? You looking mighty fine today. Mighty fine today. Oh, down goes the Sarco. Hello. That ankle is pretty hurt, too. Why don't we capitalize on both of these? Yeah, we're capitalizing on this shit. We can probably... Yeah, look at that. That's a good amount of XP waiting to happen. Oh, look at that. That's at least... That might be two levels right there. Let's kill the Dillo as well. Why are you running from me? I know I'm intimidating. I'm not that intimidating. Come on, I'm a nice guy. I may have just murdered some of your friends, but still, you know? Show some decency. Sheesh. All right, let's... Oh, not the dragonflies. Do we finish off the dragonflies? There's not too many of them. Only one, actually. Okay, well, let's gather what we can. Ow. I think he's harvesting us, isn't he? Not harvesting us, but attacking us. Get out of here. Dumb dragonfly. There we go. I've been poisoned. Crap. Where is he? I'm shanking in the air. I don't see him. Did I kill him? There's no way I killed him. He's flown off. It's a deception. It's a lie. Well, it's not a lie for now. So that's the good news. All right. We didn't make more spears. I thought we would. We can, however, make another. We cannot. Well, I want at least two more wood foundations before we do anything. We can make the better item loop or that stuff if we want for now, though. Go up in health. We don't have another level waiting for us, but we should be darn close. That's really good. The Argentavis might give us a good chunk of XP, maybe. Yeah, we just gotta... That's what we gotta do, just find ways to get XP. Crafting, of course. Actually, crafting building should get us an absolute ton of XP now that I think about it. I completely forgot. You get a poop ton of stuff just for building up, like, bases and whatnot. So if we get some wood foundations going... I don't see nothing wrong with that. Yeah, that should be pretty good. Should be pretty good. There we go. Yeah, that leveled us up nice and easy. And then we got the wall as well. Foundations definitely give more experience than walls. Let's go ahead, hit 150. Then we'll start working on carry weight. So we can hopefully carry more and be productive. There we go. Let's then also throw the wall. Not there, but there. And the worst case, we'll elongate it and make it kind of a... long 2x whatever, so like a 2x5, for example. We could make it a 3x something, but for now, we're not worrying about aesthetics. We can worry about aesthetics later on. Right now, we're worrying about not dying, because that is always a problem. Death is bad. We can't move. Okay, let's get a couple more. We can only get one. Of course we can. We need some more fiber, too. Let's get some fiber going. Let's pick it up. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, up, up. There we go. We can not expand this way. Of course we can't. Of course we can't. Of course I place... I deserve a degree in stupidity, man. We'll make it... Well, I don't know what to do except keep building at this point. So, I mean, all we gotta do is just keep hitting trees. That's to be self-explanatory and hopefully get to a point where we can build this and it won't be in a bad location. We need to get some more, yeah, we do need to get some more fibre going. Okay, I'll just mass gather some fiber. If we had a Gigantopithecus, so that would be useful right now. There should, right here, be enough fiber to get a bunch of stuff. I think we are, like, so close to getting a level that picking these berries should give us a level. Yeah, game, make it happen, please. Please, I know you want to make it happen. We can't even... Well, man, we've been effectively screwed. We really cannot place this at... Okay, well, we're going to have to use some ceilings to actually do anything with this. Well, that sucks. We can't even, like, we build this way. We can build that way, I guess. Hey, we got a level. Woo! Didn't hit the level that matters yet, though. All right, let's get some weight at this point. Start working on that. Probably demolish this wall because looks like we're expanding some more. And we're going to have to use ceilings to expand more, which is always fun. So we just got to stockpile walls. So really, stockpile wood since we're able to stockpile our fiber. Right? Where's our fiber? Fiber, don't run from me. Yeah, 100. That's plenty. And then doing just the walls should finish up the job. And life should be easy. Life should be good. There we go. We got this. Just get a little bit more wood. Already over encumbered. Doesn't matter. I don't care. We're going to get some walls. And everything will be okay. God, I hope everything will be okay. Because we just got cheated so hard. Although that's entirely my fault. Because I could have really prevented that with any use of my brain at all. However, I tend to kind of ignore that aspect and, you know, kind of neglect my brain. You know, who needs a brain after all? It's kind of, it's overrated at time. JK, brains are awesome. I gotta learn to love mine more. We could probably keep expanding the foundations this way, though. And maybe this way we'll be able to have it, something a little bit thicker without resorting to ceilings, which is kind of just what I'm going for right now. Because right now, the rest of that base is going to need to be ceilings, which sucks because making ceilings sucks. So let's make one foundation and hope that this works. Also, because the foundations give us way more XP. There we go. Okay, well, we can keep going that way. And we can go this way. Yay! We can actually start going out. So we make a little 2x2 here at least. And then the rest will be ceilings. So that's a redeeming quality, I guess. Something that's a little bit better. Yeah, yay, right? Oh, we might need to make a wood ramp too because there's really not a good way of getting into our base. We did make it difficult to walk into our base, although if someone's breaking into our base, they'll just hit it a lot, so that doesn't really save us from people. one more wood foundation at the very least, and let's get some more walls going since this foundation should level us up. Did not level us up, of course it didn't. We can't build there, but we can finish that off. And we got the level. We hit 10, boys and girls. We hit 10, laddies. Hallelujah. We hit 10. And we can go ahead and get ourselves... Do we have the wooden ramp? Can we not make a wooden ramp yet? Oh my god, of course we can't make a wooden ramp yet. Lies, man. That's all we're being fed. Lies. Let's get a ceiling. No, we need the thatch ceiling first. Okay. Thatch ceiling. Where are you? Thatch roof. And now wooden ceiling? Yes. 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 Yeah. Now we just gotta wait till 15 and we don't have access to a ramp. Oh, a wooden cage. We should definitely have one of these outside as like a fear factor. I've actually never built the wooden cage. How much is that? Decent amount of resources. I mean, we could just live in the wooden cage for now. As weird as that sounds. I mean, be protective. Am I right? No, it wouldn't be too protective. I mean, it'd keep us locked in. I don't know if we'd even be able to get out. All we need is a little bit more. We should finally be done with the foundation grind at the very least. We'll get around to finishing this. No, we do have to finish it ASAP. Actually, our ceilings, they're less wood. Okay, so that'll be nicer at least when we're making the ceilings in those spots. It will be a little bit easier for us. However, this base building will get us to a very nice level early on, and already within 2 episodes, we've broken 10. Although the early levels are never the hard parts, so it's still going to be really... We still got to work pretty hard to get to this, but at the very least, we can get to work on ceilings at this point. We're over encumbered, but let's waddle our way. Come on. Come on, I believe in your game. Come on. Little bit for... Ah, there we go. Waddle our way over here. Get ourselves a little bit more wood. And voila, we should be able to craft up 2 wooden ceilings. Are we still over encumbered? No, I don't think so. We should be good. And then let's throw the wooden ceilings into the 9 slot. And there we go. That's what I like to see. We can throw those here. It's going to look wrong. And I think wooden ceilings are weaker than foundations, so people can't break into it. But maybe we can like throw some walls here. I think you can do that, right? Can I build a wall? No, we should be able to build a wall if we get a little bit more, though. So we'll build the wall first, because I did want to see something, and this could at least potentially protect us from harm. Because what I'm thinking here is we can, okay, so we can do that. So at the very least, we can kind of armor our ceilings, which should help a little bit. We don't have to do that right away, though, because I don't think anything is an imminent threat. Also, we should probably make our actual doorway here, since this is a little bit more level. So we'll actually demolish that. Make the doorway. JK, we need more wood, don't we? No, it's fiber. Damn, I thought we had a lot of fiber. I guess not. Yeah, after this, though, we just need some wood ceilings and actually a lot more walls, but... Now we should be able to get around to that and shouldn't be too big of a deal. And we should have ourselves a nice 2x5 base to begin with. So pretty roomy, plenty of room to expand with the staircase and go into upstairs. And just have our PvE base ready to go. Don't aggro me, Dillo. Thank you for not... Oh my god, that's a first. The Dillo didn't aggro us. Those things aggro us from long distance. They're like taking collect calls. And they just like aggro us. And for the first time in history, we actually just avoided a Dillo. Aggro. I don't know what to do. I'm so happy with my life right now. This might be the pinnacle of my life. I should just, you know, I don't know what I should just do. I should just be happy because this is an amazing moment, guys. Oh my god. The Dillo didn't aggro us. That's a special Dillo. He cares about us. He's a caring person. Thank you, Dillo, for being such an understanding fellow. I appreciate it so much. Okay. Now that the tears are over, back to productivity, back to throwing down some walls. Actually, do we even really need a ceiling? Well, obviously we do, but I mean, this is still pretty early on. I don't think people are too insane with what they have. So we should be relatively not awful. And we already have ourselves a doorway. Let's make sure that this is it locked? Okay, so it is locked. Is this locked? Set pin code. I'll do that off camera. I don't want you guys knowing what my pin code is. And what did I say? One more ceiling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more walls, and we'll at the very least be encased and safe. However, something aerial would still probably... No! It broke again. Something aerial would still... Oh my god, do you see that thing? Is that a monkey? What did that furb would just kill over there? Did you guys see that? What was that? What the... I just saw like a little ball of something. I want to say it's a monkey because that's the only thing that's really that small. Actually, maybe a dodo. Actually, dodo is a lot more likely. I don't think a Dillo could really catch a Mesopithecus. We could make a wooden cage. Except I really don't want to make a wooden cage. We probably need a little bit more wood too. We're really close with this, but we just need a little bit more. Oh, that best not have been a Dillo sound I heard. Because that sounded like an aggro. No, it's a compy. Oh, I'm sorry, Compy. I didn't mean to do that. Come on. I'm not that bad of a person. Compy, stop it. It's a level 44 Compy. Hey, Zeus, man. Jesus. At least that gave us, like, some decent XP. And some more hide, which is always good to stockpile. Keep working on that weight so we can keep on carrying more and more. Throw the ceilings back into there. I don't know how we lost the ceilings in our hot bar area. Can we? Yes, we can. Two more. Yeah, I don't know how. Where'd this extra ceiling come from? Unless we just crafted it and replaced the ceiling in our hot bar with something weird. Actually, that's probably exactly what happened. Oh, we didn't have room for, like, the walls. Okay, let's get rid of that. Start making the walls. And pretty soon here, with 3 more walls, we will have an encased base. And shortly after that, let's actually throw our bed down. That's in our storage box. Okay, I was about to be like, don't tell me we lost that bed. That bed was fantastic. There we go. Throw our bed down, probably just next to the storage chest, to be honest. Nothing too drastic. There we go. Voila, look at that. Nice little sleeping station there. And I'm just gonna set a couple more walls. Wall this off. Someone could always YOLO jump into here, but they won't really get much. And I don't think people are really in the aggressive mindset yet. So hopefully when we come back, everything will be okay. But we should be able to just get ourselves... this last bit of wood. Is that a dragonfly? Is that the dragonfly we killed? I think so. Oh, sweet. Let's get some chitin. Hell yeah. That's easy. Hell no. We need some food. Campfire. ASAP. We are cooking up some of that meat. Ooh. We're going to lose all of this meat since I'm not going to be around for a while. Damn, that sucks. I mean, I'm sure we can recover. And especially, we really want to get those walls going downwards because... we want to protect our encampment a little bit. Where's the campfire going? We'll put it at the feet of our bed. That's actually a kind of a cool spot. Keep our toes warm in case we're, you know, sleeping. And access the inventory. We'll throw in 2 stacks of the stuff. We'll throw in... We need more wood. I recognize that. 1 wood will not keep that going for any amount of time. And you know what else is awesome? We're really close to water, so we're not going to be dying of thirst anytime soon. And we can make some water skins probably pretty soon as well. But we'll get around to those when necessary, when we're about to travel out. Because right now, it's really not necessary. That should be plenty of wood. And we just need to get enough wood to get... Oh, no, we should probably wait for this and eat. Because we're going to be very hungry. Actually, never mind. We got plenty of berries. Just munch on those. Eh. Munch, 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 munch. Munch, munch, panda. Come on. There we go. All right. Despite the fact we've deforested about everything close to us, we should be getting pretty close to this. And everything should be okay. We need 120 more wood. Hopefully no more fiber. And the magic will happen. We'll have ourselves an enclosed base. And unless someone really wants to try, and by that I mean unless someone wants to give a lick of effort into getting into our base, they really won't be able to. But I think people understand. This isn't my PvP base, so I don't think people are going to be stealing stuff from me. But once we do get the PvP base going, that thing has to be safe right off the bat. Do not want to be losing that stuff. Anyways, let's get some wood walls. 3 of them. Am I not mistaken? We need 3. Yes, we do. Look at that. Beautiful. Perfect number. Get those walls crafting. Still extremely slow. We can't beat it. Okay, there we go. And we can throw the walls down. And, oh, hello, Dillo. Oh, really? That's how you want to end the episode. By destroying our friendship. I see how it is. Oh my god, and destroying my eyes, too. You. Hate you. Dillos. I dislike you with a passion. I still can't see. There we go. Thank you, game. I don't even actually see. Are there more Dillos here? Best not be. Yeah, there we go. I mean, yeah, if someone really wants to, they can just jump in like that. But I will keep the dinos out. You know, keep anything aggressive from killing us, hopefully. And do we want to throw anything into here? Well, anything valuable. So let's honestly just throw everything that kind of matters to us on the off chance that we do die. Just so we don't lose anything too important. Berries will probably go bad. Yeah, I don't foresee us keeping those for too long. Those are definitely going to be gone. Chitin, definitely. Those are really nice. Fibrae. A hide, for sure. We have a good amount of hide. That's the blueprint. And, yeah. My armor, too. Let's take that off and throw that in. We can't throw enough armor in there. We'll take the wood. We'll take the charcoal, because there's going to be plenty of that to spare. And fiber, too, I guess. I don't really need fiber. We'll put those away. And we'll go to sleep naked. You know? Because that's what we do. Ow! I just punched my... Wait, did I just punch... Oh, no. I punched the bed on accident. I meant to crouch. There we go. But other than that, guys, that's going to go ahead and do it for me. So, thank you guys so much for watching the video, as always. Like I said, this new season of Tribe Wars is going to be exciting, if it does follow through as that. And I can't wait to see what happens. But for now, this is our PvE base. It's got to build it up so we can get a strong foundation, some strong stuff, and begin the PvP base. And life is going to be good. This season is going to be good, and hopefully you guys are looking forward to it. I really am, but other than that, that's going to go ahead and do it for me. So thank you guys for watching the video as always, and hopefully, see you next one.